Hi everyone, in this video we have a binary operation called star, and it's defined by this beautiful table here. So let me just highlight the table here so you can see it a little bit better. So that is our table. And so how it works is you can just use the table to compute the operation. So if you do B star A, you would get D. A star A would be A, so like A star B. So if you had to compute A star B, how that works is you just go to the table and you go to A and B, so A star B. So that would be C, okay? If you did, say, C star C, right? So C star C, how that works is you just go C star C, so C star C. So you go left, you do this one first, then this one. So that would be A, that would be A. Okay, the question has a couple parts, so let's go through it. So C star D, C star D. So C star D is going to be equal to A, right? C star D is A, so that's A, right? You just do this one first, then this one. You go in order, left to right, very important. What about D star C? Ah, so D star C here, whoops, D star C would be here, would be also A. So again, C star D is equal to A, boom. D star C is also equal to A. So they're both equal to A in that case. What about B star D? So B star D, B star D would be C. Again, B star D would be C. D star B is B, right? Again, B star D, so you just, boom, right there, that's where they meet. And then D starred with B is B, right there. We want to know if A star B star C, we want to know what that is. Okay, so how does this work? You do what's in the parentheses first. So we have A star and then B star C. So we haven't worked out B star C yet, so we have to work it out. So let's see, B star C, so B star C is B, right? Because you do B, then you do C, so B. So we have A star B. We did work out A star B earlier, but let's do it again. A star B is C. So that's C. So we get C there. Now let's do this one. This first says we do A star B, then we start with C. So A star B is C. So this is C star C. C star C is A. C star C is equal to A, right? C star C is equal to A. So now we want to answer a couple questions. Is it commutative or is it associative? So commutative means that X star Y equals Y star X for all X and Y. Associative means that X star Y star Z is the same thing as X star Y star Z. So if you star X and Y, then you start with Z, it's the same as starring Y and Z, then starring it with X. So this has to be true for all elements, right, in the set, right, in order for it to be commutative and associative. So let's first see if this is true for all elements. X star Y equals Y star X. So here, C star D is A and D star C is A. So these elements do commute. However, B star D equals C and D star B equals B. So these don't commute. So all it takes is for you to find one example where this fails. If you find one example where it fails, it's not commutative. So the answer is no for the commutivity part, right? It would have to be true for all the pairs, right? So these would have to be the same, right? They all would have to be the same. Whenever you star them and you flip them like this, they would have to be true. As long as you find one where it fails, not commutative. Associative, again, it has to be true for all X, Y, and Z. So here we have A star B star C equals C, and then A star B star C equals A. So it's certainly not associative either. So I hope this video has been helpful to someone out there working on this stuff. Take care.